My name is Ashley Henderson. I work at USAID in the Office of Education on the Education in Crisis and Conflict team. And I'm here to talk about our Rapid Education and Risk Analysis Toolkit, or RERA, as we call it for short. We've conducted, from the Office of Education for USAID, several RERAs since we put out the toolkit methodology, and they've proven very useful in helping to inform program design and program modification. In El Salvador, we conducted a rapid education and risk analysis that helped us figure out that there were some schools that had better relationships with the surrounding community, and that those schools were faring better in situations of gang violence, even when they were in really high-level violence areas. And that was very helpful knowledge to figure out. It had concrete manifestations that are sometimes counterintuitive if you really extrapolate that conclusion to its logical end. A lot of schools wanted to put up walls around their soccer fields because they considered them protective to keep the kids safe from whatever was outside. But actually, we found that sometimes these barriers would cut a relationship with the community, and it was really important to have that visibility and that connection instead. So counterintuitively, that was not a protective measure for children. A rapid education and risk analysis is very useful in education and conflict and crisis contexts because our contexts are often complex and changing, whether it's a protracted crisis, political unrest, or natural hazard like typhoon or a cyclone or an earthquake. We need to make sure that we understand in real time how the education system has been affected by these contextual risks, how student learning and access to school is affected by these risks, and how those risks interact with one another. You start by putting together a great team of experts led by a skilled consultant who either has experience in conflict analysis and education assessment, and leading a team of data collectors in the field. And you have an education expert and a risk expert, and that risk will vary by context. So if you're working in El Salvador, you may have a gang violence expert. If you're working in East Africa, you may be focusing on school-related gender-based violence, and you'll have someone who has expertise in that subject instead. So once you get your expert team together, you're also going to need some support in logistics, some local knowledge, and some enumerators, so some people who are experienced in data collection and facilitation. The rapid education and risk analysis looks at a couple ways at collecting information. It starts with looking at what's already out there. We don't want to duplicate things. We want to use what exists. And so we do that through a desk review, a thorough desk review that's really important in the rapid education risk analysis process for dictating how much primary data we'll collect and what type of primary data we'll collect afterwards, because we don't want to collect anything we already have. Then you'll need to go ahead and working with your USAID mission staff on the ground, figure out what are the central research questions to examine that relationship that I talked about earlier between the contextual risks and the education sector, so specific to your country. So taking those broad global research questions and making sure that they are applicable to your context. Once we've got our team together, we've done a great desk review, then we go out to the field and we conduct some primary research. It's very interesting because you get to go out and talk to schools, teachers, principals, local government officials, students, and community members. So this is a really exciting time to ground truth your assumptions, any sort of conclusions that you've made to date with your desk review, and to dig a little deeper on tough questions. This is primary data collection. We need to be conflict sensitive. So you need to be very careful about who you're asking, where you're asking these questions on complex topics, such as school-related gender-based violence or gang affiliation or ideology. These are topics that are best broached carefully, and sometimes it's inappropriate to discuss them with young children. So that's a very brief summary of a much longer process. But they've been really helpful in finding tailored local responses to contextual issues that are directly impacting students' learning and students' access to education.